okay.
This is normally like my least favorite piece to click, because it doesn't normally sound like that. So, thank you. Goodness. How long have you been working on it?
Since January. End of January.
That's it? Wow, you're a crazy big bank. Wow, it sounds really fantastic.
On the 20th of March.
Okay, so you saw it.
And work.
Okay. Do you have
yes.
Some new things? We already get any of the which is beautiful. It sounds great. Could you be a little clearer in your articulation on the beats? So not like a really hard attack, but it's just like pretty interesting how they are solved. Trombone 1, where's first trombone? And letter A, can you kind of lean in dynamically to the D that happens in the second half of the bar? That's the only part of how it changes is what is your part. Everyone else just holds steady and then you go to the D. But I couldn't hear that. So there's a little more volume on that. Similar note in the second, third, fourth, fifth bar A for tenor saxophone and bassoon 2. Horn 4 and trombone 2, just a little more when you come in on the second, on the half notes, right off. You should not be down on the 2. Just a little more volume to that, just so I can hear that. Mm-hmm. Just, that's great. Let's see. This first credit solo, where are you? Can you, you are playing what it says. I mean, letter V, your solo letter V, can you do a little bit more crescendo through the top of the line? And then you're doing so much diminuendo that by the time you get that B flat again, it's not. So maybe just a little bit more crescendo and not quite so much diminuendo going to the last one. And then I think all the first variants of letter C, you should exaggerate your crescendo. You have pencil. Okay. Saxophone. Well, first of all, I love like conducting the whole thing. The tempo is great. Really, really great. Saxophones lead to letter E. That retard two before E is perfect in tempo, but could you guys exaggerate the crescendo much more? So you're going like camera, mezzo forte, which mezzo forte is like unheard of in this piece at that point. So that should be really striking weight today. And make sure you don't start to back off until you've gotten to where it's marked mezzo forte, and then you get that half note. So the peak is that fourth half. And if you can also add vibrato as you crescendo, so start that thing, that measure 41, 240, start at straight tone, and then as you crescendo, add vibrato. But then we also take away the part. I'm trying to make it sound like strings. So I'm strings, you would like warm the sound as you do the crescendo like that. That's the way. I think in letter E in the second bar, that B flat to the C should probably be a solo. I think that's gonna be really tough to get out of tune first lead. Mm-hmm. So you do have two bass clarinets, right?
Yes.
Three.
Oh, wow. Okay, so all the parts are covered. In letter F, I just didn't hear the fourth bar of F.
Yes.
That A didn't speak. Mm-hmm. So, and it's double in double bass, but since you don't have double bass, it's very important that clearly that it speaks on beat two, and then the other one comes up here, which I did hear one. I love how you do the tempos leading to H. I think it's great. 140 is where that guitar is. Mm-hmm. Can you guys, in the last two quarter notes, one before H, pull back dynamically even more? So that when we get to H, it's quieter than it is right now. It sounds kind of loud. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to give away that there's going to be like the big loud statement of the tune later. So this should be like, trumpets are more forte because you got it at the bottom of the register. But don't, everybody just be sure you play the banana if you have the part. So a lot of your piano, but some of the bass instruments are mezzo forte, and you're on fifths, because that gets like pedal organ sound, like does the organ thing, it gets some richer. But if you all try to match things around you, then it'll all work. Just be careful about that.
Lead decay.
This is hard. It sounds like everyone is taking a breath before the downbeat of K, which I kind of get because it's subtly loud in K, but finally you get fortissimo for everybody. But you can't all take a breath at the same place. Because right now, it's like, bill, bah! And my knee is like, come on, push it all the way through so it connects to the downbeat of K. And the horns are really, really good in the stuff in K. If that's the one place where I wish you'd do more retard.
Right, yeah.
Like that much, and it sits on the dissonance, and then it goes back.
Right.
So that's a big, that whole, I mean, the whole piece is a big rip-off, but that beat, that part in particular, is stolen from the second movement of the Barbara Brown feature. But he doesn't cellos. I thought horns would be louder, and you don't have cellos. Trombones. So, at letter N, I couldn't hear you when you come in on the, like, right off the downbeat. You're probably conducting that in two, I assume, at letter N?
And no, we're in four.
Okay, so yeah, so if you've got a big old B2, then be sure you come in really strong on B2. Because everybody else knows on the downbeat, but I just couldn't hear that counter volume. And maybe you're saving it for the crescendo, but the more important thing is that B flat on B2 at the end.
What am I right there? Oh, that says. Oh, it says wow!
Good.
that's the second bar of O, the first horn solo is great. So then you got wow. It's a stupid hard first horn part. I apologize if you already played first horn. So, yeah. Sorry. It's really. It sounded super easy on the computer, and then like with people, it's much harder.
Yeah,
tempo, yeah, tempo's good. He actually picked up the tempo at S, and I like that a lot. That's the part of the piece where I was like, oh, it's way too slow. I should have made this faster, and you made it faster, so you fixed it. Piccolo. This is where I'm going to stay. I ran out of flutes, so, because there are only two flute parts. But at 125, you have that G to F sharp, and you're kind of being correct on too, but you are taking the line of the flutes, so the flutes are going to start over. So I think just a little bit louder. That's a terrible register for piccolo. Yeah. So it just clothed not quite forte, but like it will never be loud. It's a piccolo, and it's like the bottom fourth of the instrument. So bass drum. I know you're very busy back there, but can I give you more play? can I give you like a really, really quiet roll on the last chord of the piece? It means you'll have to pay attention because you've got like 90 bars of rest before the last bar of the piece. So he might be in Q, but I just think it's really, really nice on the very last chord, just the resolution of the last bar.
Last bar.
Yeah, it's like really quiet because it'll sound like an organ pedal. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's okay. If it's, as long as it's so quiet that you don't hear the attack of the head on the head.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that's going to be an issue. The pressure is more than that's all kind of thing. Yeah.
Sounds really great. That sounds wonderful.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.